J-Ray 501 here. Somebody sent me this, and I thought it was something sweet. We all need something sweet now and then to think about. This is, let me just read this. During the chaos of the 9/11 attacks, where almost 3,000 people died, nearly 100 loyal search and rescue dogs and their brave owners scoured Ground Zero for survivors. Now, 10 years on, just 12 of these heroic canines survived, and they have been commemorated in a touching series of portraits entitled Retrieved. The dogs worked tirelessly to search for anyone trapped alive in the rubble, along with countless emergency service workers and members of the public. Traveling across 9 states in the U.S. from Texas to Maryland, Dutch photographer Charlotte Dumas, 34, captured the remaining dogs in their twilight years in their homes, where they still live with their handlers, a full decade on from 9/11. Their stories have now been compiled in a book called Retrieved, which is released on Friday in advance of the 10th anniversary of the attack. Noted for her touching portraits of animals, especially dogs, Charlotte wanted Retrieved to mark not only the anniversary of the September 2001 attack, but also as a way to offer special recognition for some of the first responders and their dogs. I thought this was a turning point, especially for the dogs, who, although they are not forgotten, have not been as prominent as other stories surrounding 9/11. Explained Charlotte, who splits her time between New York and Amsterdam. They speak to us as a different species, and animals are greatly important. They enhance our sense of empathy and teach us to put things in perspective. Scout and other unknown dog lie among the rubble at Ground Zero, just 2 of nearly 100 search and rescue animals who help to search for survivors. Handler Julie Noyes and Hokey were deployed to the World Trade Center from their home in Denver on September 24th and searched for 5 days. Abigail was deployed on the evening of September 17th, searching for 10 days, while Tuff arrived in New York at 11 p.m. on the day of attack to start working early the next day. I don't know if that's worded right, but oh. Aren't they cute? This is Red from Maryland. Berlin and his handler, Matt Clausen, were deployed to Ground Zero on September 24th, working a night shift for 5 days. Guinness, 15, from Highland, California, started work with Sheila McKee on the morning of September 13th, was deployed for 11 days. Radigny and his owner Denise Corliss from Cypress, Texas, arrived at the site in New York on September 17th, remaining there for 10 days. Kaiser, pictured at his home in Indianapolis, Indiana, was deployed to the World Trade Center on September 11th and searched tirelessly for people in the rubble. Tara, 16, from Ipswich, Massachusetts, arrived at the World Trade Center on the night of the 11th. The dog and her handler, Lee Prentice, were there for 8 days. Their eyes say everything you need to know about them. Some of the true heroes of 9/11 are still with us today. God bless all the handlers, and God bless all these animals for doing their patriotic duty for this country. God bless.